Hi, this is Robert Galarowitz, naturopath, nutritionist, and kidney disease sufferer. Now, I made this video because I want to talk about sodium intake and kidney disease. Now, behind me, you're going to see a few things listed. I'm going to go through them. Now, this year, 2013, there were two studies published. One was in the Journal of Heart in June 2013, and the other was in the International Urology and Nephrology Journal, January 2013. And what both of these studies looked at was lowering sodium intake and kidney disease. Now, the first one in the Journal of Heart, what they did was they had people with kidney disease, chronic kidney disease, lower their salt intake. And what they found at the end of the study was that people with lower salt intake had a lower blood pressure. And why is this good with kidney disease? Because one of the biggest factors with kidney disease is controlling blood pressure. If you don't control your blood pressure, it's only going to lead to further damage of your kidneys, accelerate any kidney disease, and make your situation overall much worse. Now, by lowering the sodium intake, you can keep your blood pressure low, which in turn helps the kidney. It takes the stress off the kidney. Now, in the other journal, the International Journal of Urology and Nephrology, they had people lower their sodium intake, and what they found was at the end of the study, people who had a lower salt sodium intake had three inflammation markers that actually decreased. Now, with kidney disease, there's usually going to be a degree of inflammation, and by lowering inflammation, you'll just improve your kidney disease, improve the health of your kidneys all around. So this is two excellent reasons why you really want to keep your salt intake low if you have any type of kidney disease. Now, I want to talk about a few ways that you can lower your salt intake listed behind me. So one of them is avoiding adding salt to foods. Okay, pretty simple. You want to avoid adding salt to any of your meals and to any of your cooking. You know, this alone usually provides a good drop in your sodium intake. Now, second is restaurants. Whenever you eat out at any restaurant, takeout place, any type of eatery at all, they always add salt to the food. And what you can ask your server to ask the kitchen if they cannot add any salt to your food. And they're I don't know of any place that won't accommodate this unless they pre-prepared some of the foods. Now, another one is condiments. Okay, you really want to watch out for condiments. Things like ketchup, salad dressing, mustards, because a lot of time they have a lot of sodium intake in them. Ketchup especially is loaded with sodium. And so you can try looking for lower sodium options for these condiments. Now, the fourth one is packaged and convenience foods. Now, packaged convenience foods are always going to have a lot of salt added to them. So if you're buying any type of canned goods, any type of packaged foods at all, you always want to check the sodium intake to make sure that you're not, you know, consuming a lot of it. So these are just some simple tips. Now, anyone with kidney disease should be trying to keep their sodium intake preferably under 1,500 milligrams a day, 1,500 being the max. If you can't, no more than 2,000 milligrams a day. And this is just one dietary lifestyle tip that you can use to help your kidney disease. And there's actually many, many, many other things that you can do to help any type of kidney disease that you have, from diet, nutritional, to lifestyle. And I have a free video on my website that has more of these tips. You can visit my website by going to www.healkidneydisease.com. It's www.healkidneydisease.com. And there's a free video there with more tips on how to help your kidney disease. Thanks for watching. Bye.